Hi children, welcome to grade 4 English and this is our session 2 in chapter number 11, The Clever Jackal Gets Away. And before getting into our session, let's recall the story, The Clever Jackal Gets Away. Once, Gogo the wolf began one evening calling her grandchildren and they talked about cleverness and why it is very important thing to own and how cleverness has helped everyone from her stories. And Sifo, whose nickname was Fungusi, he asked his grandmother, "The jackal is also a clever animal, isn't he, Gogo?" And Gogo, in fact, had given him that nickname because of the loud howl he had made as a baby. But Sifo liked to think that it was because he was quick and agile like the jackal. Gogo laughed and looked at the child at her feet, that is Sifo, and answered, "Yes, my boy, you are right. The jackal is a very clever animal, sometimes too clever for its own good." And here, the grandchildren of Gogo, they chorused and they asked Gogo to tell them a story, that is a tale about jackal. And all right, my children, listen to the story and learn. Gogo settled more comfortably upon the tree stump and started telling the story. One day, long ago, jackal was trotting through a narrow rocky pass as he often did. And he kept his nose to the ground as he ambled along to catch the odd scent, and he was searching for his food. And he thought to himself, "When I will happen upon my next meal?" Although it was highly unlikely that he could find a rat out in the midday heat, perhaps he would catch a lizard or two. Suddenly, he was aware of a movement ahead of him in the pass. "Oh no," jackal moaned and stopped dead still in his tracks. There he saw a lion coming towards him, and it is none other than Bubesi. Realizing that he was too near to escape, jackal was filled with fear. He had played so many tricks on the great Bubesi in the past, and now he was very sure that the lion would take this opportunity to get his revenge. "Help, help," cried the jackal. In a fraction of a second, in a flash, the jackal thought of a plan. The lion stopped short in surprise. The lion remembered very well that jackal had tricked him so many times. The lion wanted to give it back to him this time. "Help, help," jackal howled, using the fear he felt in the middle of his chest to accentuate his cry. Jackal glanced up at Bubesi and said, "Oh great one, please help. There is no time to lose. See those great rocks above us. They are about to fall and we both shall be crushed to death. Oh mighty lion, do something and please save us," the jackal cowered. Bubesi looked up most alarmed. He even had a chance to think. Jackal was begging him to use his strength to hold up the overhanging rock. So Bubesi put his brawny shoulder to the rock and heaved as a support. "Oh, thank you, great king," helped jackal. "I will quickly fetch that log over there to prop under the rock and we will both be saved," he said. With that, jackal bound out of sight, that is, he escaped. Now, lion was left all alone to struggle under the weight of the unmoving rock. How long he remained there before he realized that it was another trick and we will never know. But one thing we know very well, that the jackal continued to live by his wits very happily. And the moral we learn from this story is, in today's times, being smart and clever is a necessary quality for each and every one of us. But it is very important that it doesn't mean hurting others. We should not hurt others at any cost. And children, in today's session, we are going to learn the concept connection phrasal verbs. And we have already learned about verbs and prepositions. Verbs are nothing but action words, and preposition tell us about the position of a noun. And now let's learn how verbs and prepositions are used together in sentences. And we are going to learn about phrasal verbs. A phrasal verb is a verb plus a preposition, which together means something quite different from the original verb. For example, the thief broke into the house. Here, broke is verb, into is preposition. They both combine together to make a phrasal verb. Some of the common verbs that are used to form phrasal verbs are put, set, break, get, bring, and take. Here is the list of three phrasal verbs formed with each of these verbs. Break, break out, break through, break up. Set, set in, set out, and set up. Take, take away, take up, take on. Put, put up, put into, put away. Get, get up, get off, get into. Bring, bring up, bring in, bring out. And children, I hope you are clear with today's session. That is, we learn the concept connection phrasal verbs, right? It is nothing but verb combined with preposition to form phrasal verb. Yes? And now let's do some class activity related to the concept connection. In your practice zone 2, question number 1, look up your dictionary to find the meanings of the following phrasal verbs: break out, break through, set up, take away, and get into. Children, you have to find meanings for these words in dictionary, and after that you have to make sentences using them. Right? Yes. And second one, fill in the blanks with the phrasal verbs given in the box below. Read the sentences carefully and fill in the blanks with suitable phrasal verbs given in the help box. And I hope you have completed the class activity, right? And let's summarize what we have learned today. And we have revised the story, The Clever Jackal Gets Away. And we have learned this lesson that we have to be clever and smart in today's times to be successful in our life. And also we have learned the concept connection phrasal verbs and completed practice zone 2, question number 1 and 2, right? And now let me tell you the home assignment for today's session. Children, read the concept connection phrasal verbs thoroughly in your concept book, page number 171, right? And after that, you have to complete the question practice zone 1, question number 5. What did Jackal sense while he was ambling along? And 6th, did the lion get tricked into the Jackal's plan and how? And 7th one, what does the story tell us about the Jackal? And 8th, how did the Jackal plan to escape from the lion? Answer all these questions referring the story, and then you have to complete in your workbook question number 1, what you liked in the story, question number 2, what you learned from the story, and question number 3, you have to draw your favorite character or scene from the story, The Clever Jackal Gets Away, right? And after that, you have to complete question number 9. Imagine what would happen if the jackal had got stuck under the falling rocks instead of the lion Bubesi, right? And unlike what has been given in the story, how would it change the ending of the story? Write the new ending in the space given below. And children, I hope you have completed the new ending to the story, right? And now, based on this, here they have given you some questions. That is question number 10, A1, was the jackal able to save himself in your new story, that is in your new ending? And B question, how is your ending more interesting than the ending given in the book? And C, in what ways is the new story more modern and interesting? Right? And children, after completing all these answers, you have to hand in your completed work in grade 4 English Google Classroom. Children, drink more water, eat healthy food, reduce your screen time, don't use mobile phone and television often, stay home and stay safe, children. Thank you so much.